Birbhum is a district where there was always scarcity of water. In the 19th century, Zamindari system of governance was very prominent. It was a popular practice for the landlords to make new settlements by bringing in subjects from the nearby places. The landlord of Raipur, Bhuvan Mohan Singho, allowed some people to settle in the western side of Bolpur Shantiniketan Road. However, shortage of water was a huge problem. In those days, digging a water tank was considered to be a sacred activity. Hence, Bhuvan Mohan made the Boro Bandh, meaning elder tank. It was built on 75 bigha of land. He also dug many wells around it. A signboard says that it was done around 1826. In around 1863, Maharshi Devendranath Tagore acquired this area. This was the primary source of water for the entire Shantiniketan. It was renovated two times. In his lecture, Jalotsargo, Rabindranath Tagore says that it was made further deep in 1936. Later, in 1951, again, it was dug deeper to increase its capacity. The soil that was dug out was thrown in the field nearby. Today, that field is called as Posh Mela Ground. A water pump was set up in the northern side of the tank, which supplied water to the hostels of Vishwabharati. There was only one kitchen for the entire university, and that too had the same water. Because of this water scarcity, the university had summer holidays for nearly 2 months. Since the last two centuries, this huge water tank has been the primary source of water for Bhubannanga and Gurupalli area. The name of the place Bhubannanga comes from its founder Bhuvan Mohan Singho. Even today, people come here on a regular basis. During the Posh Mela, which happens in December every year, Bandh is the main source of water. It is a place with fishes, trees and people living among them in the heart of Shantiniketan. Due to immense tourist inflow during December, this place is prone to pollution. We must not forget its usefulness in the life of local people and conserve this beautiful creation.